Hey everybody, welcome back to Dr. Cranky's Laboratory. On today's menu, mud, dirt and mud. We're going to be mud flinging or mud spattering, and I'm going to walk you through how you do it, all right? Here's what you need. A little bit of plaster, okay? Not a lot, so you get one of these little shot things that come with the medicine that you get if you have a cough or whatever and you know, fill it up halfway. You're going to need a raggedy old brush. The more raggedy and used and messed up, the better, okay? You are going to need your mud, aka Earth Effects, and the aka Dust Effects, okay? And what I did was I mixed them. You can mix these things up so that it's a little bit lighter, a little bit darker. If you use them by themselves, this is really dark and this is really light. Since we're dealing with a, in this case, sort of a desert type of vehicle, okay, we are going for a lighter color, all right? So I don't want to show you too much of this build until I'm ready, but we're going to be doing the under chassis. We're going to be mud spattering, and we're also going to be doing the rolling chassis. I've already done the tires a little bit, but I'm going to show you first how to practice on the airbrush. All right, I'll be right back. All right, we're back. Before we get into the actual airbrushing and practicing of the spatter, I want to show you how to mix it. So far, I've mixed a little bit, okay, and it's a little thin. You want it thin, but, you know, the first coat, I like for it to go on a little bit thicker. So what you do is, you know, you mix a little bit of plaster into the mix, okay, and you go like that. You mix it really, really well. Okay, then, right, you make sure you've got enough of it. Okay, in the old days, okay, what a lot of the guys would do would be like, you know, you could tap. I don't know if you could see that. You could tap, but it doesn't give you, you know, the kind of controlled, you could tap a little bit and it falls on there. Now, with the airbrush, I'm going to show you in just a second, you can have a little bit more control using less material, and it'll give you fine results. So, be right back with the airbrush. All right, one thing before we airbrush, a lot of times we're in the shop and we're using chemicals, and we think, oh, we really shouldn't protect our lungs. You know, these days, I'm not doing it now because I'm going to be talking, but these days, every time I'm spraying any kind of thing, I'm going to wear a mask. I have my big, you know, industrial mask for when I do house of color and other types of paints. But even when I'm mixing liquids, I just got this in the mail. I got it from Coast Airbrush. It's one of these RZ masks that the guys who do dirt biking and all of that wear for protection, I guess, from the dust or what have you. And it's very light and very friendly. And basically what you do is you just, it's absolutely wonderful. It's got the filter already on the inside, so you come on in and you basically it's that simple, and now suddenly you have some protection, or at least, you know, you're going to be getting some of that stuff screened out of your lungs. And this will be good for any time, you know, you're mixing stuff that makes it really smelly, you know. So it's good investment. It's not cheap, but it's, you know, at least it makes me feel a lot safer and better. All right. So anyway, I'll be right back with the airbrushing. All right. So the mixture is mixed. Don't worry too much about the plaster setting up on you, because for some reason the oil products, because that's what the AK Interactive products are. They are oil based. So basically they're not going to dry on you, so you've got plenty of time. You've got plenty of time to do this. So anyway, load up the brush, right? Load up the brush, not with too much material. All right. Then I'm going to crank up the airbrush. I've got my airbrush ready. It's my workhorse, the Iwata. So I'm going to show you how this works. All right, so we're back. I put on the compressor, right? You're just blowing air, okay? The brush is loaded. Here we go. And you try to just shoot it at a tip. Think of the way it happens in real vehicles, all right? Coming up from the tires onto the fenders and lower body panels, all right? Here we go. See? You begin to see it. Okay, so you could, just a little bit goes a long ways. You could start building layers, okay? So I've been practicing all morning, right? I love doing this. It's one of the pleasant things about building a model. So I'm going to try it now on the chassis. Let me get the chassis over here. This is the rolling chassis. Okay, now the tires are there, so I'm just going to load up again. All right. Remove the excess. You don't want, again, you just want the tip. And you want to remove all of the excess before you go. Okay, we're ready. So here we go. Just light. I mean, you don't have to go that crazy on it, just so that it, you get a little bit on there, all right? Now I'm gonna do the under chassis here, the part of the body, and this should be a lot of fun, right? Remember, move the stuff that you've already done out of the way. You don't wanna overdo it, okay? So here, you do the fender wells around the wheels. You know, this type of thing gets everywhere, gets on the body everywhere, so, you know, there's no way to make a mistake. You're just spraying it on, okay? And then you do the front fenders, and again, just a little bit goes a long ways. That was too much. That's why you practice on a piece of paper. You keep it on there. And then you just come back in and there we go. And it's not like it's going to dry on you right away, but you want to be careful. You know, you don't want to get a lot on there. You want to go slow, building up layers. That's what it's all about. Building up layers. All right, it's that simple and it's not much fun. So, and as I said, there's no wrong way of doing it. I mean, you don't want to cover the entire model with this stuff. You just want to give it a particular look. All right, I'm turning it over and now it's more delicate because you really just want to get it, you know, just a little bit. There, I got a little bit too much, but that's okay because it's going to dry. It's going to blend right in. So you just want to do a little bit of that on that side. And then you turn it over. Load up some more. And you go on this side. And it's going to be, this time it's going to be a little bit of, you know, dry dust, dry desert mud. And you can go as subtle as you want. I would not overdo it. And that's it. That's pretty much it. Right? And next time you see this, it'll be a glamour shot. I'm going to do a video of it so that you can see the finished product. So mudslinging, mud spatter is that simple. You just practice a little bit. Build up your comfort zone and then let it fly. Until next time, Dr. Cranky and Igor say goodbye.
Good boy, Igor. Good boy. Good boy.